generations going on. So it looks like everybody, could you see, was there a big evolution from your childhood concept to your current concept? Or was it fairly similar? Very similar. Who started out with no idea to a very firmly held belief? Did anyone follow that continuum? Okay, who felt that it was just a gradual evolution? Okay, well, that seems to be quite a few people. All right, well, I'll share my opinion. That's all it is. Angels never had a physical existence as we do. They're not in, the way I see the universe is like there are many, many ranges of frequencies, different levels of energy and vibration. Does anyone have a dog in here? Anybody have a pet owner? As you know, dogs can hear things that we don't hear. They can smell things that we don't smell because their range of hearing and smelling is way, way bigger than ours. So it's not that, obviously those sounds are there, we just don't hear them. So the angels are in a wavelength that most of us cannot see them or hear them. Some people do. Are you familiar with Lorna Byrne?
Yes.
Are her books available in Swedish?
Yes.
Okay. Lorna Byrne, I believe, has a world-level mission to wake the world up, particularly the West. But she does travel beyond the West to the reality of the spirit realm. And Lorna Byrne sees angels the way I see you. Mm-hmm. They're very substantial to her. She sees into frequencies that most of us cannot. I don't usually see angels physically. Even when I do see them, I see them in my mind's eye. And it's usually for a reason. You know, I feel their presence, I feel their love, I feel their support, but that's not how they manifest to me sometimes they manifest as in a very physical form. But usually when that happens, you're not aware of it. It's later when you think about it, you realize, oh, that doesn't make any sense. We'll come back to that one. Angels are pure energy of a very high vibration, a very high frequency. They have the capacity, they do have the ability to bring their vibration down to the earth ranges and to appear in substantial form, to appear as physical beings. There are many, many, many references in the Bible where they visited and ate food, and when they disappeared, the food went with them. They have done a lot of physical things. So they're pure energy. And we are too, actually. We're pure energy. You know, this, what we consider to be solid, this is my little Swedish angel here, what we consider to be solid, it's energy. It's just moving at a certain rate of speed. Einstein, I believe, said energy is not created or destroyed, it only changes form. So if you take ice and you apply heat, it will become water. And if you continue to apply heat, it will become steam. It's still H2O, but it can go, depending on heat, it will expand or contract. So angels are energy beings, spirit, what we would call spiritual beings. But that's only because our range of awareness is very limited. Mankind was created by God to be fully aware of the spiritual world, to live in not only the physical world, but the spiritual world too. But something went wrong in the beginning, and we lost our connection to God, and we've been searching to heal that connection ever since. In Christianity, it's called the fall of man. And somehow that connection was broken. In the Bible, it says God was walking in the Garden of Eden in the cool of the evening. Okay, in the evening, it's getting dark, isn't it? And he said, Adam, where are you? And Adam said, I hid because I was ashamed. Why were you ashamed? Because I'm naked. Who told you you're naked? I wasn't ashamed of being naked the day before. Little children love to be naked. It's a very natural state for them. They feel free. They're not ashamed. They have to acquire that shame as they get older. and then they want to cover themselves. So this was the fruit of this disruption, this break that happened between the Creator and humankind. So angels are beings of pure energy. The Christian, in, I don't know if people here are familiar, some of you probably have some background with the Bible, know the traditional Bible stories, but it says that one third of the angels left the presence of God. One third of the angels went. When Lucifer and Eve, however you want to take that story, had their interaction and she decided to eat of the fruit, Lucifer and his angels separated themselves from God. Well, that means two thirds of them stayed loyal and stayed faithful. And those are the ones we want to mobilize. Now, sometimes people ask, well, how can you tell the difference? It's really not that hard. You know, Jesus said you will know them by their fruits. Have you ever heard of the seven deadly sins?
Yes.
Pride, lust, avarice, etc. And then the fruits of the Spirit, peace, patience, understanding, etc. So you'll know by the fruits. Is it something that makes people puffed up and proud and wanting to give instruction and direction where it's not asked for? Or is it something that makes people humble and serving and just willing to become a minus? My husband was praying, he was meditating and thinking, what exactly is an angel? And he saw this, it looked like a wall of water appeared before him, just like a shimmering energy. And he looked at it, and all of a sudden, a face came through. Ooh. You know those that little game that they have, the little pins, and you put your face in it. We played it with our kids, with our grandkids, and then it came out. Said, "We can be whatever we need to be." So angels can manifest in many different ways. Now, this is an exercise that I would like you to do with your partner. This is a team exercise. Okay. Does everybody have paper and pencil?
Yes.
Okay. Get out. You only need one per team. So if everybody can bring one, that's okay. You need a pen or a pencil and one sheet of paper for each pair.
Don't pop it.
Each odd and even pair. Now, I'm going to give you a few minutes. I forgot to prepare a prize. This is a competition.
Oh.
I should have had a chocolate ball or something. I want you to think, did anyone go to Sunday school in their childhood?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, so you've heard Bible stories. You know the Bible stories, right? If you're someone who has no childhood Bible experience, you can rely on your partner. Do I have two partners that have no childhood exposure? We'll give you another partner because we want to give you a fair edge. Now, I want you to write down every story that you can remember from the Bible, Old Testament or New Testament, involving angels. Okay, I'm going to give you a few minutes. Work together and just try to remember. And write down what you remember. All the mentions in the Bible are angels. I'll give you a head start. An angel came to me.